begin by the history of event management in India. Event management came into being around the early 1990s when liberalization happened in the country, when large multinationals started coming in and started feeling the need of a specific agency to organize an event or a campaign. Before that, there were various company owners, tent house owners, advertising agency owners who used to organize events on their own. And in the early 1990s, people started realizing the need of a separate entity to organize events in the country. I remember when we started out in 1996, we used to go to corporates and we used to try and explain to them, why do they need an agency? The first question they used to ask us was, why should I hire a specific agency? This is something that everybody does. But slowly and surely, they realized that it is a specialist job and they require specialists to do it, to do it better than the way they can do it, to do it in a more efficient, in a more cost effective, and in a far more impactful manner than the way they usually did it. So let me begin by explaining to you what is the difference between ATL and BTL. ATL stands for above the line, BTL stands for below the line. Above the line means conventional forms of advertising, whether it's radio or print or media or television or outdoor or any form of mass media where there is a one-way communication where we are informing the audience about a particular product. BTL, on the other hand, stands for below the line communication. Below the line means where there is a direct contact with the consumer. That is where event management comes in. Whatever we do provides an experience to the consumer. And as you know, friends, in today's day and age, information doesn't matter, experience matters. If you know about a particular mobile phone, you may not buy it. If you experience, if you hold it, touch it, feel it, use it, experience it, the chances of you going for it would be much higher. And that is precisely the role that event management plays in marketing today, in marketing promotions, which is why the budgets are slowly shifting towards events, towards experience, and people are realizing the power of experiences. So this was the journey from early 1990s till 2014, where from being something which was not even recognized as a career option, not even recognized as a requirement, to today where it's absolutely it is an integral part of any marketeer's budget. I don't think any marketeer in the country would afford to ignore event management as a means to reach out to their consumers today. I'd like to take a couple of minutes and show you a short video that we have created about Vibgeor, which essays our journey into this beautiful field over the last few years. So can we have the video, please?
Many things go into the making of a great event. Unique ideas, obsessive planning, and of course, keeping a finger on the pulse of the audience. We believe that every brand is different, and every brand deserves a unique voice, a new story, an experience that is simply unlike any other.
Vibgeor has been at the forefront of the experiential marketing industry for over a decade now. Actually, much before the term experiential marketing was coined. Through this journey, we've worked with some of the best brands and have created experiences that amaze. It's a process that brings us pure excitement. And once you've tasted that feeling, there's nothing else quite like it.
Creating great brand experiences can take us everywhere. From the biggest shopping malls to the bylanes of rural India, we like to connect with consumers in new and different ways, in ways they just can't forget. At Vibgeor, the focus is quite simple. We're not in the business of creating executions. We are in the business of creating great experiences. And while we love the madness of it all, great brand experiences always start with the brief.
It all starts with the brief. We read it, we study it, scrutinize it, obsess over it, and then we read it again.
Until we get to a strategy, one that's clear, inspiring, and most importantly, that works.
We are big on brainstorming, strategizing, of thinking inside out, and sometimes outside in. With copious amounts of coffee by our side, we obsess over the smallest of details, working out all the angles. If anything, a decade of experience tells us that you can never be overprepared. The impact that our projects create has made us a familiar face at industry awards.
The silver in this category goes to Vibgeor for Lakme.
But while the awards might speak for themselves, it is connecting with different people that gives us the adrenaline rush. We get your brand up close to the right people and in the right places, from college campuses to small towns, from fun zones for children to friendly neighborhood markets. On the roads or in sports fields, we are there wherever your consumer is. What makes us come to work every day? It's a love of brands and creating unique experiences for them. It's something we've done for a very long time, with color, energy and a style that is uniquely Bibcure.
So let me explain to you how is event management used as a tool for experiential marketing in today's situation. What are the different kinds of events? First, let's talk about that. So there are three major fields which any event management company operates in. The first is what is called large scale, small scale, corporate, social events. Events means where there is a certain audience, which is a captive audience, which has come there to experience that particular event which is going on. It could be a sunburn, it could be a wedding event, it could be a corporate event, it could be a dealer meet, it could be an employee meet, it could be a social event, it could be a political event. Event means where there is a captive audience. That is what an event holds. Where the audience is coming, they are getting some sort of an experience, some education, some information, whatever it is. The second is brand promotions, experiential marketing, below the line, whatever you'd like to call it. That is the area that we specialize in, which is where there is a two-way communication between a brand and its consumers, where we first try and assess who is the target audience for a particular brand and then reach out to them in the most effective and efficient manner. We try and create disruptions in their life. We try and create a situation where they are forced to stand up and notice a particular brand and notice it in such a way that tomorrow that brand will be in their consideration set when they are about to purchase. That is the most important thing. So if I tell you about a particular brand when you're not interested to listen, then my brand promotion is not a successful promotion. I need to create a slot in your life where you are willing to listen, where a consumer of a particular brand is willing to listen, is willing to absorb information and is willing to give his time and energy. Today's consumers, they're short on time. We need to reach out. So there is a certain set of consumers who would be relaxed in a pub, who would like to know about a particular brand of liquor which may be launched. There may be a certain set of consumers who are relaxed in an airport lounge, who while waiting would like to know the features of a new mobile phone. There may be a certain set of consumers, women, girls for instance, who would be relaxed in a salon environment where they'd like to know the new shades of lipstick which have been launched, and so on and so forth. There may be certain children who may be in an environment in a mall where they are open to learning, to knowing more about the new flavors of ice cream which have come in. And the third type is exhibitions and display. And then there are various other forms also which are related. So for example, sports events is there, like I said, political events are there, and various other types. But companies like ours specialize in these three major, so events, experiential marketing and exhibitions. So we are here to talk about experiential marketing. What are the key ingredients of an experiential marketing campaign? How does it help brands? What are the things that an experiential marketer needs to look for success of a particular campaign? So the first thing that needs to be kept in mind is the target audience. Like I said, unless and until who you want to reach out to, you will never be able to reach out to them. So the marketeer is always very clear that my target audience is somebody who can afford a car worth 10 lakhs, who lives in an upmarket society in South Delhi, who has two children, blah blah blah. So there has to be a very clear profiling on who we are talking to. Then is where we are talking to them. We need to talk to them, like I said, we need to talk to them at a time when they are willing to listen to us. So who we are talking to, where we are talking to them, how we are talking to them. It's very critical to disrupt what they are doing, to create an impact so that tomorrow there is a lingering thought in their minds about that particular campaign, that particular product. So who we are talking to, where we are talking to them, how we are talking to them, and second is we don't need to talk to them, we need to engage with them. So there has to be a two-way communication, there has to be a feedback. So these are the three, four critical things that you need to create an impactful experience. You need to be clear about who you're speaking to, you need to be clear about what are their likes, dislikes, where is it that they are likely to hear you most, and you need to engage with them, which means you don't need to just talk down upon them, you need to engage with them. So today's experiential marketing campaigns take all these four elements and add various other layers, various layers like outdoor, like radio, like social media. Social media has become an integral part of any experiential marketing campaign today. So we create an event, we create a Facebook page about that event, we create a Twitter handle about that event. I will show you a few case studies going forward where we have used social media very extensively to promote and to make our experiential marketing campaign successful. So I will just take you through some slides of a PowerPoint presentation. The first slide is about who we are. I've already spoken to you about this. We are WibGeor. We've been in this field for about 12 years. We have executed more than 15,000 projects in the last 12 years, and we worked with some of the best known corporates across the country, including Hindustan Lever, Dabur, L'Oreal, Nestle, Nikon, ITC, Philips, etc., etc. What are the different kinds of things that are there as part of this portfolio? There's brand activation, there's corporate events, there's exhibitions, new market introductions, precision sampling. I'll just take a minute here to explain to you what are the different career opportunities that are there in event management. There are three or four integral departments which are required by any event management company. The first, and in my opinion the most important, is the client servicing business development department. These are the people who are the face of the company, who represent the company in front of clients, who go and get the business, who give the ideas, who do the communication, who are always at the forefront. The second is the creative team. These are the people who think up of the crazy ideas, who make the crazy designs, who basically add the value that helps us win projects. And the third are, of course, the operations, the hands and legs. So if I, the operations is what makes these dreams come true. We sell dreams to our clients. We don't have any particular product that we are selling, but we are selling a hope, we are selling an idea. And the people who execute this idea, the people who bring these dreams to life, are the operations people. So, I mean, other than these, the regular departments, like in any other company, are HR, IT, Marcom, admin, etc., etc., which are common to most companies. However, experiential marketing has these three fields, which are interesting career opportunities: client servicing business development, creative, and operations. If I were to compare them to body parts, the client servicing business development is the face of the organization, the creative is the brain of the organization, and the operations is the hands and legs. Remove one of these three and the whole show goes flat. As I said, we use a lot of technology. Today, technology has become an integral part of any event or any event integrated marketing campaign where experience is required. So whether it is the use of audiovisual technology or it's the use of new things like 3D mapping, I'm sure in subsequent lectures we will talk about the different technologies that are into the field today, or it's things like RFID, technologies on social media, technologies on mobile. Today, we are creating apps for a lot of the events. So where our consumers download a particular app, and if they want to participate in that event, if they want to give feedback of that event, all they have to do is just type in from their mobiles. So I'd like to share some of our selected work with you now, some of the projects that we are proud of and that we feel are interesting experiential marketing campaigns. These are all projects which have been done in the last 1 year or so. First one is for ITC. This was a project called Uber Cruise for a new range called Aquafresh by ITC of men's toiletries. These included shower gels and bathing bars and talcs and various other toiletries. Now, the client wanted to reach out to their audience, which is predominantly young males between the age of 16 to 20 living in metro cities. This was a very cool product which had something to do with water. They wanted something fresh, they wanted something which reaches out to this audience and something which stands out. So they said that we want young males who are trendy to notice our brand, to participate in our brand, and to understand that this is Aquafresh. So this is, the feeling is like being at sea. being in the ocean. The feeling is like surfing or being in the ocean. That was the brief to us. So we went back to our creative team, and we came back with an idea of creating something called an Uber cruise. So this cruise, we created a 40 feet by 40 feet cruise in the middle of a mall. So large malls were selected, like Ambience Mall, like Garuda Mall in Bangalore, etc., in all the top metro cities. And we actually created a cruise in the middle of a mall, which was 30 feet, actually more than 30, about 40 feet long. It had a sail which was 40 feet high, and people from all over the mall came just to see what this cruise was all about. We created a surface which was like a water surface, and we created a virtual reality game where you could come inside the cruise and actually get inside the game, and you could navigate the cruise in the ocean. And of course, then people could come and try the product, could try Aquafresh. So this was something which was hugely loved by the audience, it was supposed to be a one city activity, and it was carried all across the country by the client. And we created a great experience. We had huge number of people who took part in it, who tried the products, who sampled the product and took part in the experience. So this was called Uber Cruise by Fiamma de Wills. Next, let me talk about something which we did just about a few months ago. This was for a lipstick called Maybelline Superstay 14. This lipstick has a unique feature, which is that it stays on for 14 hours. The client said, we want something which engages our audience in metro cities, which using a lipstick where the message that the lipstick stays on for 14 hours is there. So we created a Twitter handle called What Doesn't Last Long Enough. And women across these metro cities were encouraged to send tweets on what doesn't last long enough. So we had enough crazy tweets. We had girls tweeting that their boyfriends don't last long enough, their money doesn't last long enough, their credit card doesn't last long enough, their fuel doesn't last long enough, and so on and so forth. We created a huge screen at Phoenix Mall in Bombay, where we integrated the technology to bring these tweets live to the mall, live to the screen. And there was a clock normally has 12 hours. So we had a clock which had 14 hours instead of 12 hours. And we created this 14-hour tweet-a-thon where these tweets were coming in, and it was forming the shape of a lipstick. At the end of the 14 hours, all the tweets were in the shape of a lipstick on this large screen. Another very interesting activity we did for a brand called WeChat, which is owned by Ibibo. Now, WeChat, as you some of you would know, is a messaging service. So WeChat is a product which is owned by Ibibo, and it's pretty much similar to WhatsApp, and it's a chatting service on the mobile phone. They wanted something to attract couples and to reach out to a large number of people on Valentine's Day and get them to download this app. So they said, we want something unique which will get us PR mileage, which will get us coverage, and where people are pushed to download this app on their mobile. So with this brief, we created a simple concept. We created the largest Valentine's cake that has ever happened in India, 18 foot wide by 18 foot long, and we created in such a way that if you scan the cake from anywhere in the mall, you would automatically be redirected to the WeChat application on your mobile phone. So we set up this at Ambience Mall in Gurgaon, the largest cake. We had enough media, we had enough couples. All the couples who were there to spend Valentine's Day took notice of it. They stood across four floors of the mall and they scanned, and we had more than 10,000 people who actually downloaded this application on that particular day. And WeChat was hugely talked about, WeChat was hugely written about, and WeChat was hugely downloaded. So it actually created a spike in their marketing activities. So this was India's biggest QR code in the form of a cake. And after all this was done at a particular time in the evening, at about 6 o'clock in the evening, the cake was cut and it was given free of cost to all the couples who had downloaded it. So it was a great celebration that was done at the mall. These are some of the events. This is for the Indian Express Group. We create these properties which are awards in different fields. So these are called the Ramnath Goenka Excellence in Journalism Awards. This was a particular event. This was another very interesting activity very recently held for Reckitt Benckiser. They wanted to promote wheat and the fact that girls can confidently walk across the city looking confident and beautiful in short clothes with the help of wheat. So they have a brand ambassador called Nargis Fakhri, and we created this concept called Walk of Confidence, where they had a talent hunt of girls across the country, where more than 4,000 girls participated. We got them all together in an event, got 10 winners out of them, and then them along with some models and Narges Fakhri walked through the busy streets of Delhi using wheat and wearing short clothes. And we said, what is the busiest part of Delhi? And the answer was Chandni Chowk. So we took them from a hotel in Connaught Place to a metro ride to Chandni Chowk to Red Fort, and we called it the Wheat Walk of Confidence, and it gathered huge PR mileage, and you know, thousands and thousands of girls and consumers got excited, and the brand was extremely thrilled about it. So this was for wheat, called the Walk of Confidence. For Calabar, we did an experiential. Calabar is another brand which is into cosmetics. So we did an experiential pop-up store which gave makeovers, and there was a fashion show, and in various malls we do this pop-up zone. For Maybelline Superstay 14, we created a New York. So Maybelline is an iconic brand from New York, so we created a virtual New York at malls. I will talk about Horlicks Nutrition Academy. Now Horlicks is a brand into nutrition. They wanted to reach out to people in tier 2 and tier 3 cities, so we created this truck on which we had a nutritionist who was sitting and giving people free consultation about what are the different foods that they should consume for their nutrition requirements to be complete. So people would come onto the truck and she would say, you need to consume 4 eggs a day and 5 whatever, 4 glasses of milk and so on and so forth, or you could have 1 cup of Horlicks morning and evening. So the brand message was given in a very subtle way. We had queues of people lining up to meet this nutritionist and get her opinion on what should be their diet, and subtly trying to push Horlicks as well. So Horlicks Nutrition Academy was done in about 22 cities, hugely successful campaign where we had nutritionists, we had promoters, we had some activities, and it was all about suggesting people what should be their right diet for their nutritional requirements. Chocola, this was a brand of chocolates in urban markets where we created, normally Christmas is associated with the colors white and red. We created a chocolate Christmas at all malls where they are present. So we had a chocolate tree, we had Santas in chocolate colored. So I'm just trying to showcase different types of activities which have been done. There are various other case studies which you can visit on our website, which is www.vibgear.in. There is our email ID, etc., which is given on the website. So if you have any queries, we'd be most happy to revert to you. So I had spoken about what are the career opportunities. The key career opportunities are in client servicing, business development and operations. And a unique sampling platform that we created called GoTry. So we have been doing a lot of sampling. A lot of these FMCG clients such as Dabur, Hindustan Lever, Perfetti, ITC, etc. need to do a lot of sampling to their target audience. And very often they are not able to reach out to the perfect target audience because they don't have the right data. So we've set up these kiosks at Delhi and Mumbai at the moment, which sample multiple products from the same kiosk, multiple non-competing products. So there would be a shaving cream and a shampoo and a shoe polish all from the same stall. So we have 15 to 20 multiple products from the same stall, which helps reduce the cost for the brand by 1/10. And once a consumer comes in, we take their perfect data. So we will ask them, how many children do you have, what school did you go to, how many cars do you have, what is your disposable income, and we profile them once, and then each time they come to the mall, they are given 4 to 5 products which are relevant to them if they give feedback of the previous set of products. So it's a win-win situation for both, for the brands as well as the consumers. Each time the consumers are coming to those malls or metro stations or railway stations, they are coming, they are getting products which are relevant to them, and the brands are getting to reach out to consumers which are perfectly suited to them, as well as getting feedback. So we've created this particular intellectual property called GoTry for this. So friends, this was a short talk about experiential marketing and about the use of event management as a brand promotion tool. If there is anything that you require, you can write to me at anko.kalra@gmail.com. I try and satisfy your queries. Thanks so much for listening in, and hope to see you soon. Thank you.